what can they expect? I mean, we're going right back to the origins of Footsoldier, right back to the first ones, the darkness, the grittiness of these three guys that were very much addicted to drugs and caused a lot of mayhem. Sorry, I'm sweating so bad here. But yeah, I think the fans can expect a lot of action, but with a good story at the heart of it. You know, it's got a really great story, and I think we're all very proud of it. Terry Stone's never been better as Tony Tucker, and I think it's... I think the fans are going to love it. I really do.
I think that literally shining a light on the origins of some of these characters are going to change fans' appreciation for the people that they already know and love.
I think so, and I think that was the whole point of it, to do something before the beginnings of number one. Because, you know, we're five films deep into this franchise now, and I think that the fans kind of were asking for that. You know, where do these characters come from? Who are they? What are they about? So that's what this film's about.
You talk about the look and feel of the film, because I think we've already heard that, you know, the envelope's been pushed a little bit, and that's a special element of the film.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you talk about pushing the envelope. You know, I mean, this is the biggest cast of any Footsoldier. It's, it's got more action than most of the Footsoldiers. It's a great script written by myself and Andy Loveday. I think if you want to talk about pushing the boat out, getting that new vibe into it, got a whole new cast of characters, I think that's what it's all about.
Talking about Terry, what makes him such a very special performer, and why is he such an amazing fit for this role?
Oh, mate, listen, he embodies everything that this character is. He's played it a few times now in different films. He knows the character inside and out. But with this film, I wanted just to do a little bit of a rebranding, not too much drugs and laughing and chaos. I wanted people to get to the heart of this guy. And you know, when you're doing that much drugs, whatever comes up must come down. And and sometimes we never see that in the movies. We just see the fun and the laughing and all the piss taking. But this really shows the consequences of what they were doing, the consequences of drugs and the consequences of your actions.
And obviously this isn't the end for Footsoldier. We've got another film in production. Can you talk a little bit about that next evolution for the series?
Well, I'm not massively privy to it, but I've heard different things, because I know that Andy and Carnaby want to do something that ties in from number four, because we left that very much open-ended. But I don't know is the answer. I don't know. Watch this space, I guess.
I guess when fans get a chance to see this film here or beyond, what are you most hoping overall they take away from this particular installment in the saga?
I just really hope they take away just a really good watch, you know, a really good movie. They sit there, they enjoy themselves for an hour and 45 minutes, and they go, at the end of it, they go, what a ride. What a ride. I really enjoyed it.
Can you start by telling us a little bit about what fans of the franchise and this character can expect from this new and exciting chapter?
Well, they're not going to know what to expect, because they've only seen Tony Tucker, you know, when he's obviously been on drugs and he's been, you know, sort of just brought in, you know, halfway through the movie. It's the first film, explores his character, goes into his background, and it connects the dots, so you can actually see how all the characters met, how the journey is. And if you're a Foot Soldier fan, this connects all the dots for every single Foot Soldier. So if you look at them five films, the fans will go, oh, that was from that. So you need to see this film if you've seen any of them. But I think when you actually watch this film, if you haven't seen any of the others, you can watch the standalone film and then you'll want to watch the others. So,
and I mean, obviously fans want to see every aspect of those characters' journey. What is it for you as a storyteller, though, about this character that makes him so interesting to play and has kept you coming back for more and more of that story?
Well, I think, I don't think anybody's ever seen Tony Tucker like this. And that's really what excited me, because when I sat down with Nick and we were chatting about it, he went, I want people to watch this film and go, now, is that really what happened? And actually buy into not just the performances, but the journey of the character, the emotions, the whole thing. And, you know, I think between us, we nailed it. And when I watched the film, you know, I was just pleased. You know, sometimes you watch films as an actor and you're not pleased, or as a producer, and you go, oh, we could have done this, we could have done that. There is nothing we could have done any better on this film, not one thing. Working with Vinny, Keith Allen, Nick, Andy, I mean, you know, Rachel Warren, Josh Myers, all of them. There wasn't one person who came on a set and didn't perform. You know, they all done. I mean, me and Roland, you know, Tony and Craig, you know, we spent 4 weeks together. And I think the characters, a lot of people say they love that dynamic between us, but I think in this one they're going to have it. So I've got a couple of movies. I've done a documentary about the UK garage scene, which I was a big part of when I had Garage Nation. So we've got a documentary about that coming out, like a feature. And I've also been in another film, which I played the lead in, called The Last Heist, which is a Reservoir Dogs type movie with a bank heist. Another true crime movie. Got some great actors from this film and some other films in it. And that should hopefully be out later this year.
I guess my final question, obviously, why do you think that the world that films like Footsoldier and Last Heist explore, why do you think they catch our imagination so much? We literally can't get enough of that world.
Because they're f***ing brilliant. No, I tell what it is. I think people like crime films. And I just think if you make a good crime film, people want to keep watching them. And that's why the Footsoldier franchises, there's been five of them, you know. There's not one British crime film that's had a true crime film franchise. It's the only one, so.
Hello, my name is Rachel Warren.
Rachel, it's amazing to have you over tonight. Can you tell us a little bit about where you fit into this wonderful slice of cinema?
So I am playing the leading lady, Lucy, in Rise of the Footsoldier, Tony Tucker's story. The gangster franchise, it's like the fifth now. It's the fifth and the final one of the franchise. I feel quite honoured to have been cast as Lucy as well. It's quite a male-heavy film. So being cast as Lucy was, you know, I'm very humble and very grateful for the opportunity. So my character, what I was really, really, really excited about is to transform. So myself, my background isn't so much from the gangster world. So what I really, really love doing with Lucy, I was able to let go. I was able to take all my layers off and I was able to become somebody else. And I actually, while I was on set, could believe that as well. So it was a real big challenge for me to make sure that Lucy is believable and realistic on screen. And yeah, I'm going to go and see it for myself very soon.
You mentioned, obviously, it's a very male-dominated world. What was it like being on set with the rest of the cast? What was that experience like?
So being on set, in the male-dominant cast was absolutely fine. I embraced it. And to be honest with you, the cast that were there, they're all, like, true professionals. A lot of banter. I must say, I had a bellyache every single night from laughing so much at, like, Essex jokes and Essex banter. I learned what the word mustard meant. I thought, you know, they were outside in the hotel and they were like, oh, yeah, my room's mustard. And I was like, oh, my room's cream. So we had these little moments. I know what big boats mean, mustard, like all of these other words. It was a joy. It was a joy. I loved every minute of it.
Is there anything else you've got coming up at the moment?
So I am currently producing and acting in a three-hander feature film that I've been working on for the last year. I'm not allowed to say yet. I really wish I could, because I could scream the rooftop off. But I have actually signed up a very prestigious actor to play my father. And then we're in negotiations right now for a fabulous actor to play my on-screen boyfriend.
Hello, my name is Kat Ronson. I'm an actress in the film.
Kat, it's amazing to have you here tonight. Can you tell us a little bit about where you fit into the film?
Where do I fit in? I play Carly, and I fit in being on drugs, partying, shaking my booty. That's how I fit in. That's what Carly does, basically.
Was it liberating to play a character who's clearly having that much fun?
Yeah, it was, because I think you get judged quite a lot as a woman, and to just be like, yeah. Like, she's got no inhibitions, it's the 80s, like, anything goes, so she's just having fun. So it was liberating, yeah.
And were you able to draw on your own personal experience for that, or was there a bit of acting involved?
So much acting involved? No, I did two seasons in Ibiza, so I think I know how to party. I think I'm all right at it. So it came quite naturally to me.
And aside from partying, what can fans of this franchise, you think, expect overall from this instalment?
I think it's, like, very fresh. Like, it's got some iconic actors in. Like, real British grit. So it's going to be great.
And aside from this wonderful bit of cinema, have you got anything else that you're working on or coming out at the moment?
Yeah, I've actually just finished a show last weekend, but I've still got another show next month called The Whoring Twenties. That's a comedy show, but this is my main thing at the moment that I'm celebrating.
And I guess just finally, have you got a message to fans about why they need to make sure they watch this any way they can as soon as possible?
Am I allowed to swear? Watch it, you as Vinnie Jones would say in the film, you know?
I'm Sam Gittins, I play Jacko. Jacko is kind of one of, I guess he's one of the anchors of Tony Tucker's life. He's one of his military friends, and when he comes back to Essex, he's the guy who, I guess, is part of the normal crew. So I played him like the everyman. And before Tony Tucker goes and has this sensational life of drugs, crime, women and the rest of it, he has this normal group of friends. And I guess we're there to connect the audience with the fact that he was just a normal guy who took an opportunity that sent his life on a different path from everyone else. And that's kind of what Jacko serves for the film, I guess.
I mean, for people who are a fan of the series, what do you think they're going to get from this that is unique compared to the other installments?
Well, listen, I think the first film was a very gritty, very real portrayal of the lifestyles that they lived, and they obviously followed Carlton Leach. From there, they went on and on, and they made the films very fashionable, very classy, very, you know, on point with the times. But this film's totally different. This film is a Hollywood production. It's shot on anamorphic lenses. It's got stunts, it's got explosions, it's got A-list actors. Loveday, who stood next to me, I know he's in earshot, but he has taken this film and made something completely different out of it. And I think if you love the series, prepared for it to be times by 10.
You talk a little bit about working with Nick behind the camera and a wonderful cast alongside you in front of it.
Nick's great. Nick's very intense, shouts, screams, runs about. He's like a puppy. Every idea is popping into his head, and he's not scared of shouting any one of them out. And it's great for someone like me that's a little bit jumpy themselves when they're on set. It's nice to not have a director who's constantly chilling behind the camera and waiting to say their point. He's just there. He's just there. And I think that serves the film really well, because it's got a high-octane film with a high-octane director.
Are there other things that you're in that we should be keeping an eye out as we look to the future?
Yeah, for sure. I've got a film out now called To Be Someone, which is the Quadrophenia reboot. I'm in the new Band of Brothers series, which is unnamed at the moment, but that's going to be coming out soon on the Apple TV, which we're filming at the moment. There's a few things coming out. There's a film called Last Heist that I just did with Terry Stone, actually, which us two play the lead roles of. There's a few things coming out to keep an eye on.
Just very quickly, obviously, for Band of Brothers fans, what can they expect just in general from that new sort of, you know, retelling of that story?
All I can say is what IMDb tells you. It's called Whirlwind at the moment, or Masters of Air at the moment, and it's coming out soon. I can't tell you anything else, I'm afraid.
Shot, literally. Cheers, Sam.
The install from in this film is a very dark telling of these guys, how they all started. And it's also going to tie up all the other stories of all their previous four films. So this is the film that it starts where they started, and you get to see now a bit what these characters were really, truly like. So, yeah, really exciting.
Why was it important for you guys as storytellers to explore that portion of the story, and particularly the origins of some of the characters?
I think because from the very first film, these guys appeared in the second half of the movie, and we never ever really explained where they come from and how they all met. They just appeared. So this is a story that needed to be said just to tie up the rest of the, you know, the film.
You talk about the look and feel, because I think we've already heard from some of the other cast that really it's gone Hollywood. It's pushing the budget this time.
Yeah, it feels 80s. We spent a lot of money on the production design. The sets are great. And just attention to detail. When you watch this film, it feels 1980. So, which is very unusual and low budget film.
Of course, the tagline is the beginning of the end, but I think fans are hoping it won't be entirely the end of the Footsoldier franchise. Can you talk to us about the plans that's already in place, hopefully, for more?
Yeah, we're going to do a new reboot of the brand, the Rise of the Footsoldier Millennium, and it'll be 5 years later, introducing the So Solid crew days, year 2000, and a whole brand new host of the new guys. Hey!
Hello, mate.
This guy, the main man, the boss, the main man.
I mean, just finally on that, obviously fans will be excited to see that next chapter. What excites you most as a storyteller about getting to move the story on and that So Solid crew?
To move the story on and reboot the franchise. Give everyone something, a brand new, fresh take on it for the next generations to come.